Alfa 164 is at the peak of the Alfa Romeo range. So how does it compare with its more direct competitors? Let's take the best of them for comparison. The BMW 530i, the Mercedes 300e, the 16-valve Saab 9000, and the Volvo 760 intercooler. The line of the 164 comes from Pininfarina. It's his latest masterpiece. Sober, innovative design. A dynamic, aggressive style. A compact form with nothing protruding. Alfa 164 is characterized by its low, sloping bonnet. Its short, high, composed rear. The large wheel rims and lowered tires. The recesses at the sides, including the handles flush with the door, definitely smarter than the projecting handles of the Volvo and the Saab. The rear lights, in a strip and in one single color, a new discreet solution, better than the multicolored lights of the Volvo. The Mercedes, the BMW. Overall, the result is a strikingly innovative line, smart and yet aggressive. A line which has nothing to envy its closest competitors and probably beats them. A line in step with the times, or maybe a little ahead. The line of Alfa 164. Let's go on with our comparison and have a good look inside. There's a generous amount of space here, more than many competitors, including the BMW 530i and the Mercedes 300e. It's comfortable, thanks to the special shape of the seats, much softer than the seats in the BMW, and the notoriously hard ones of the Mercedes. It's rational, because it's designed to suit various kinds of passengers, and special attention has been paid to the ergonomics. The driver's seat can be adjusted in 10 different ways, three of them for the sitting position, all of them electrically controlled. None of the competitors offer so much. Two adjustments on the steering wheel, height and inclination, while the most the best competitor offers is only one. The controls are distributed rationally and they're easy to reach. The dashboard is linear, neat and clean. The instrumentation is complete and very easy to read. Smartness and attention to detail place the 164 on an excellent quality level. It's functional for pleasurable, safe driving. Volvo 760 intercooler, CX 0.41. Saab 9000, CX 0.34. BMW 530i, CX 0.32. Mercedes 300e, CX 0.30. Alfa 164, CX 0.30. A design on the leading edge of technology. Optimal inclination on the struts. Spoiler integrated in the bumpers. Nothing sticking out. Everything optimized by long-term studies in the wind tunnel. The aerodynamic superiority of the 164 is revealed in the coast-down test. Four cars with similar CXs. The Saab, the Mercedes, the 164, and the BMW. A Corivit, a sophisticated speed detection instrument, is installed in each of them. The Corivit is connected with a yellow light on the roof of the cars and to an explosive cartridge with different colors for each car. The test begins. The four cars set off together. They drive along abreast until they touch 160 kilometers an hour. The Corivit tells us when the agreed speed has been reached by automatically turning on the yellow light. At this point, all at the same time, the four cars go into neutral. Now the only thing that can slow them down is the resistance of air. When the Corvette sees that a car has decelerated to 100 kilometers an hour, the colored cartridge explodes and marks the ground to show what distance has effectively been covered. There we are. The Saab is already below 100. The BMW 2 has slowed down to 100. Now the Mercedes cartridge explodes. And the last is the 164. In neutral, decelerating from 160 to 100, the 164 has covered 1,446 meters, 44 more than the Mercedes, 66 more than the BMW, and a good 277 more than the Saab. That is the outcome of great aerodynamics, the aerodynamics of Alpha 164. The aerodynamic perfection of the Alpha 164 also makes it noiseless on the road, all to the advantage of comfort and safety. All noise inside has been eliminated, so that people can talk and listen to music quite comfortably. Perfect soundproofing. The insulation of noise sources in the gear wheels. The use of noise-absorbing materials and the elimination of any possibility of air entering the inside have given this remarkable result. Excellent noiselessness that improves the all-round comfort of the 164. All of the sound level tests carried out on the 164 yield excellent results. The car was tested using very precise recording equipment, with four microphones installed at the listening points of the four passengers. The test was carried out both at low speed on special surfaces, different ground types transmitting special stresses to the vehicle, and at a constant medium speed of 100 kilometers an hour on a normal surface. This is the result. At 100 kilometers an hour, the noise level inside the 164 is 64 decibels. This matches the BMW and is better than the 70 decibels of the Mercedes and the 73 decibels of the Saab and the Volvo. Noiselessness, another great feature of the 164. Saab 9000, 175 horsepower. Volvo 760 intercooler, 182 horsepower. BMW 530i, 188 horsepower. Mercedes 300e, 190 horsepower. Alpha 164 3000 V6, 192 horsepower. Volvo 760 intercooler, 200 kilometers an hour. Saab 9000, 220 kilometers an hour. BMW 530i, 227 kilometers an hour. Mercedes 300e, 228 kilometers an hour. Alpha 164 3000 V6, over 230 kilometers an hour. Alpha 164 has the best acceleration from standstill to 100 in the category. Alpha 164 3000 V6 in 7.7 seconds, Mercedes 300e in 7.9 seconds, Saab 9000 in 8.3 seconds, BMW 530i in 8.6 seconds. Volvo 760 intercooler in 9.2 seconds. Alpha 164 has the best pickup in fifth gear in this category. Here we have a comparison with the latest BMW, the 530i. The two cars drive along abreast in fifth gear at 50 kilometers an hour. On this line, they accelerate to the maximum without changing gear. There we are, Alpha 164 is gaining on the BMW. The point is that the 164's fifth gear is not an overdrive as it is on its competitors. It's a true and proper gear, powerful, brilliant, giving a pickup that was unthinkable until now. Let's have a look at the result. After 1 kilometer, Alpha 164 has outdistanced the BMW by 86 meters. Let's see how Alpha 164 behaves on the road compared with the BMW 530i. These are slow motion sequences of the two cars. Alpha 164 reveals greater stability, both when leaning into a bend and when straightening up. Innovative in line, perfect in comfort. A winner in aerodynamics and noiselessness. Aggressive in performances and safe on the road. That is Alpha 164, a car for five continents. The birth of a car is the outcome of many trials, much experience and numerous audits, controls and improvements in the workshop and on the road. The star performer in all the tests is a robot driver who's been working for years, unflaggingly, patiently and painstakingly, under the watchful eyes of mechanics and technicians, simulating the experience of millions of miles on one prototype after another. His steadfastness and tenaciousness are the visible symbol of Alpha's great commitment in testing the 164. A 4 million kilometer trial. Arese, March 7th, 1984. She's a prisoner on the test bench. Balocco, March 21st, 1984. The first emotions. Lapland, January the 9th, 1985. The first adventure. Arese, Sunday, April the 14th, 1985. Prototypes tested, 7. Total kilometers, 681,205. May the 12th, 1986, the 164 takes shape. February the 15th, 1987. Intensive testing. 50 pre-production cars, 150 test drivers, from Lapland to Morocco. Objective, comfort. Objective, brakes. Objective, high performances. Objective, no noise. Objective, electromagnetic compatibility. Objective, power to the limit. July the 18th, 1987, over 4 million kilometers. She's free at last. We're in the Alfa Romeo works at Arese, near Milan. This is where they make the 164, a car that stands out as the latest interpretation of the superior class sports saloon, with a technological content and style well in line with the Alfa tradition. The production strategy for this car is based on the absolute flexibility of plant and machinery, the use of robotized systems in manufacturing and control, ongoing research in terms of quality and craftsmanship, seen as the essential counterparts of automation. The bodywork is made on fully automated lines by a system of 60 multifunctional robots. Here we see the front rib work of the body being made. At this stage, the robot performs welding, support, and handling functions. It is flexibility which justifies the large investments needed for these production systems. Flexibility is what makes it possible to use plants like these for making prestige motor cars. On the chassis manufacturing line, we see a further example of the system's flexibility. Here, the two changeover systems allow the same robot to perform two functions. automated systems came into the Arese works with the advent of the 164. Usually, they are reserved for much higher production volumes. Today, the production capacity of the line is about 250 cars a day. But these machines improve their output even more by integrating the assembly of this car with the assembly of other Alfa Romeos. Quality is born in the factory. It's born in the manufacturing stage and is consolidated in the testing stage. A sophisticated three-dimensional measuring system checks that the geometry for machining the steel bodywork complies perfectly with design values. This ensures that every body is made precisely enough to accept all the sub-assemblies that will be fitted onto it. The measuring robot carries out 80 controls at 80 points every minute. Thanks to the high operational speed of the system, the entire body can be audited in just 20 minutes. The number of errors is virtually zero. The 164 is a car designed for excellent performances, and they are guaranteed by the Alfa Romeo tradition in motor cars. We are now in the engine assembly department at Arese. Here, especially in the last stages, the experience and professional skills of man play a particularly important part. We are watching the 3000 injection engine being created. It has six V cylinders at 60 degrees. It can develop 192 horsepower DIN at 5,600 revs, one of the most powerful, flexible engines in its category. Assembled manually with the craftsman's skill, this engine is mostly built of light alloy. Responsibility for the most important assemblies is given to one single mechanic, and that guarantees a high quality standard. All of the engines, the six and four cylinder ones, the twin spark, the turbo diesel, and the turbo petrol, are subjected to a severe testing cycle. What's more, all of the six-cylinder engines are tested at full power in special cells. Let's move on to final assembly. At this point, with the body painted, The doors, which had been mounted at the bodywork assembly stage to secure perfect alignment, are removed and sent off for fitting out. The robot becomes the star once more. Assembly of the rear window and the windscreen is done fully automatically, so as to guarantee that the adhesive is evenly spread and that the glass components are fitted perfectly. This technology guarantees the maximum reliability. Operations on the doors and all the main sub-assemblies are performed in special areas off the line, where work can be done more comfortably with the latest control systems. After fitting out, the computer simulates operational conditions on all the components. Passing this test with flying colors is the essential condition for delivery of the door. In other work areas, other men fit the dashboards. And once again, it is the computer that checks for good working order, carrying out a good 38 tests before the doors are actually fitted onto the vehicle. Trimming the car needs a good deal of care and is entrusted to the hand of man. Without the doors on, it becomes easy to access the inside and move around the body, which facilitates online operations. The power unit, suspensions and braking systems are assembled on separate lines. These sub-assemblies, guided by the computer, are then sent off to their bodyworks. Coupling the mechanical sub-assemblies with the body is carried out by an automatic screwing station. The computer handles screwing operations and checks the quality and reliability of the fastening. In one of the last assembly stations, the 164, nicely trimmed and complete with all of its mechanical units, is given back its doors. After final adjustments and severe static and dynamic testing, the Alpha 164, the very synthesis of performance, pleasurable driving, fine aesthetics, personality, and prestige, is ready for its owner.
Type 4. The design carried out by Fiat, Lancia, Saab, and Alfa Romeo has led to the definition of a chassis for the top range of cars. The body shell is of high strength, and the structure is closed by the front underbody. Front wheel drive. Transverse front engine. McPherson suspension with widened base links at the front and quadrilateral at the rear. The styling has taken advantage of the opportunities deriving from a mechanical system which offers a great deal of freedom to the stylist, especially the slanting engine, which reduces its height. The new fuel system. The design of special front suspension couplings to the wheel arch and wheel hub, which allow the bonnet to be lowered. The position of the roof panel has been styled in keeping with the shape of the bonnet, thus achieving a lower car while maintaining the headroom in the passenger compartment. In terms of aerodynamics, the goals set forth have been translated into a personal style by Pininfarina, nonetheless in keeping with Alfa Romeo's image. The CX drag coefficient is 0.3, but the most important feature is the reduction of the front section to maximize aerodynamic stability. The styling achieved is also the result of specific engineering solutions, namely bonding of the windscreen and rear screen. The wraparound doors, the height of the tailgate, the slanting style of the bonnet, the overall blending of the front with the rear. And the concealed wipers. As far as the passenger compartment is concerned, the steering wheel rake and reach adjustment and the possibility to adapt the seat to various positions, including height, make it possible for every driver to have his own driving style. Alfa Romeo's tradition in the field of engines is underlined by the use of a highly sophisticated power unit in terms of both build and performance. The transverse arrangement of the powertrains involved complete rerouting and design of the fuel system, the exhaust system, the engine mountings, and the lubrication systems. The engines available for the 164 are a 3-liter V6 mounted transversely at 60 degrees, 192 DIN horsepower at 5,600 RPM, a maximum torque of 25 kilogram meters at 3,000 RPM and 24 at 2,000 RPM. A 2-liter twin-spark four-cylinder engine with twin electronic injection and phase transformer, light alloy crankcase and cylinder head. 148 DIN horsepower at 5,800 RPM, 18 kilogram meters torque at 3,000 RPM, and a maximum torque of 19 kilogram meters at 4,000 RPM. The most exciting features of the twin spark version are the optimized timing in relation to the speed of the engine. This system allows constant performance with improved power and torque. The twin ignition system, providing faster combustion, reducing fuel consumption and pollution. The 2.5-liter four-cylinder turbo diesel engine fitted with intercooler, tunnel crankcase, and modular heads. 117 DIN horsepower at 4,200 RPM, 26.3 kilogram meters maximum torque at 2,500 RPM. Compared with all the other cars of the Type 4 project, the 164 is at the top of the performance scale in each engine range. All versions of the 164 exceed 200 kilometers per hour. 230 kilometers per hour for the 3-liter V6, 210 kilometers per hour for the twin spark, and 200 kilometers per hour for the 2.5-liter turbo diesel. Acceleration from 0 to 100 kilometers per hour is 7.7 seconds for the 3-liter V6, 9.2 seconds for the 2-liter twin spark, and 10.8 seconds for the turbo diesel. Times for 1 kilometer starting at 0 kilometers per hour are 28 seconds for the 3-liter V6, 30.2 seconds for the 2-liter twin spark, and 32.2 seconds for the turbo diesel.
Length 4.555 meters. Width 1.760 meters. Height 1.400 meters. Wheelbase 2.660 meters. CX 0.30. Front wheel drive, transverse engine, disc brakes, servo assisted power steering, thousand twin spark, maximum power output 148 bhp din. Two thousand petrol turbo with overboost, maximum power output 175 bhp din. 3000 six cylinder V-shaped, maximum power output 192 bhp din. 2,500 turbo diesel with intercooler. Maximum power output 117 bhp din. McPherson all-round independent wheel suspension and anti-roll bar. Turbo diesel. Top speed 200 kilometers an hour. 2000 twin spark. Over 210 kilometers an hour. 2000 turbo. Over 220 kilometers an hour. 3000 six cylinder. 230 kilometers an hour.